Hello, beautiful people. I just wanted to come on real quick because this was a demand from you guys, a video for me to just go ahead and elaborate a little bit on what we kind of touched based on in our last Divine Feminine Energetic Guidance Tarot reading. You guys wanted me to go ahead and add some more clarity on the issue of polygamy versus incest and where that correlation exists or lies, okay? So we definitely dabbled into the simple fact that if you have a belly button, you stem from a womb man, meaning that all man, all existence, mammals included, stem from a female gender. With that being said, let's go ahead and jump right into the simple fact of what polygamy stands for. People who practice polygamy, one, understand the power of their DNA. Two, they understand the nature of hierarchy and how it used to exist in the past and how important it was to pass down that DNA, that genetic coding to the next person who stems from you, so on and so forth. So Adam and Eve, literally, we all come here on spiritual contracts, y'all. Adam and Eve had one mission amongst many. It's a lot of different purposes within our spiritual contracts, but Adam and Eve came here with one mission amongst many other things. But the main thing that they had to focus on was to do what? Create civilization. They had to populate the world. They had to make bodies, individuals. They had to spread the DNA that God put inside of them to make sure that it was going to be inside of the rest of humanity to come, okay? So literally, Eve had a specific job, and that was to utilize her womb to create more individuals so that way we can have civilization as we know it today, right? So Eve did the damn thing. Okay, and the Bible is clearly stated that Cain and Abel were the descendants of Adam and Eve. And in the Bible, it also indicates that Cain and Abel went out to populate the world, y'all. They cannot, male and male cannot reproduce. So who did they populate the world with? The only female that existed during that time, which was their mother, okay? And in today's society, we consider that to be incest. But here's the correlation. Family was a business. Why was family a business back then? Because their only business back then was to create family, y'all. Their only mission back then was to create bodies, to incarnate souls into a human form. Eve's uterus was being, God was manifesting through Eve's uterus to bring spirit form into human form. So now in today's civilization, you guys, of course, we you got Tom, Dick, and Harry out here. You don't need to sleep with your brothers and your sisters. You know what I'm saying? But back when there was nobody else, incest was very necessary. And that is why polygamists understand that family is a business and love is law, meaning no matter whose sperm reached her egg, thou shalt love one another regardless. Love is a law of the universe. You have to love people unconditionally with no type of reciprocation, determining how and when and why you love that person. You know what I'm saying? Back then, the love aspect was not confused. Everybody knew that we are put here to love on one another, to love on each other, and to spread love amongst, you know, each other regardless. You know what I'm saying? Now Eve did the damn thing. We have plenty of people. The DNA has been spread out. It's billions of people on this earth, meaning we do not need to sleep with our brothers and our sisters and our mothers and our fathers and stuff like that. But there's your correlation right there. Family was a business. Love was law. It didn't matter who got her pregnant. Their only mission here was to keep on making that womb take a soul and make a human form. So there it is right there, y'all. And that's why hierarchy is real as well. That's why back in the day, you had emperors, empresses, kings, and queens that passed it down to their descendants. The princes and the princesses stepped up. You know, they were the next people in line because that DNA was potent. So people who practice polygamy today understand that ancient cultural indigenous practice. They understand that love is law. And best believe, everybody in a polygamous relationship will let you know as well. Love is non-negotiable. Those women or those males have to love on each other like they brothers and sisters, regardless, because they understand that family is a business. Polygamous relationships is not about sex. It's not about lust. It's not about nothing but leaving that legacy behind, okay? And whether we like it or not, y'all, all our ancestors did it at one point, some way, somehow. And if you honestly want to get a better understanding about how this whole entire ideology is spread amongst humanity, look at every mammal, okay? When the female ape is in heat, she goes into a corner, okay? She goes into a secluded place. And every male ape mates with her. Every single last one of them, they mate with her. She goes and she steps off when she's in heat. And naturally, they sense it, of course. But it's not nah ape that don't get to inseminate that female. Same thing for dogs. When dogs are in heat, the males be like, where she at? Where she at? Where she at? That shows you love is law. We supposed to love one another regardless of what the circumstance is. Now, 17 billion people on this earth. You got Tom, Dick, and Harry out here. You don't have to sleep with your siblings no more. Best believe that. And just because I'm not going to be in a polygamous relationship, I don't knock it. I completely understand it, y'all. And that is where your correlation is. They had one mission, one purpose. Their only business on this earth was to create civilization as we know it. It didn't matter how that happened. Love was law. Regardless of who got her pregnant, regardless of how she got pregnant, regardless of whose baby she was popping out next, the DNA was still there because it stemmed from that one woman that came here to populate everybody as we see it today, y'all. I hope this really made sense. If y'all need more elaboration, drop it in the comments, because I would love to go a little deeper on this, but I don't want to put too much religion in this, because I understand some people believe in Lilith, some people don't believe that Adam and Eve was the first people here put on earth, but I feel like majority can understand that type of synchronicity. If y'all want me to go a little deeper with other religions, just go ahead and let me know. Because regardless, I can correlate it with every religion. And I'm very familiar with multiple religions, okay? I hope this really helped you guys. And I only did this because multiple people literally was like, Jazz, can you help me out? What you mean? Incest, polygamy. We don't have to do it today. We have enough people where our DNA has been spread more than enough. You don't have to sleep with your brothers and your sisters. But back then, there was no such thing as incest. It was polygamy. Now that there's 17 something billion people on this earth, there is a difference, okay? If that makes sense, I hope it sizzled in your spirits. And if it don't, let me know. I will be glad to go ahead and elaborate with whatever religion that you practice or spirituality that you practice. Love, peace, light, and blessings. Mwah, 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 mwah. Y'all know I love y'all.